Now let us see the proof of Leibniz formal statement. The difference between formal statement and informal statement is the limits here are not constant. In formal statement, the limits in informal statement the limits are constant. In formal statement, the limits are not constant. So similarly in informal proof, this is graph of f of t comma x and this is graph of f of t plus delta t comma x. And f of t plus delta t comma x can be written like this using Taylor expansion. So here, according to this formal statement, we need the difference in this in the area under above graph f1 and below graph f2. So the area under above graph f1 is, and as the limits of f1 are from a plus dA by dt and delta t and b plus dB by dt delta t, the area under this is I5 plus I6 plus I2 plus I3, and the area under second graph below graph F2 is I1 plus I2, since this graph is graph has the limits from A to B. Out of this, I2 gets cancelled and I4 and I6 are negligible, like they as this delta here, delta B is approximately 0 and this delta T is also approximately 0. So this area will be 0. So we can neglect I6. So finally, we have to find I5 plus I3 minus I1. Now, area under above graph F1 can be written as integral of a plus dA by dt delta t into b plus dB by dt delta t f plus df by dt delta x by dx, and area under graph f2, let's name it as af1 and af2, is a to b f dx. So we need the difference of these two areas and differentiate it with respect to time. So that is, we require integral a plus dA by dt delta t into b plus dB by dt delta t f plus df by dt delta x dx minus integral a to b f dx by delta t. So let's separate all the terms here, and I can simplify the first term, that is AF1. AF1 can be written as integral of A to B F plus DF by DT DX delta X DX minus integral F plus dou F by dou T dou X into delta t integral dx different integral and limits of b to b plus dB by dt delta t of f plus dou f by dou t into delta t into dx minus this term. So I'm doing here af minus af2, that is f dx by now by delta t, that is equal to delta t. So again, separating all these terms, like I'll separate f and df by delta t, and here f and df by dx. So we get this as, this is equal to integral a to b f dx plus a to b dou f by dou t dx delta t minus integral a to a plus dA by dt delta t f dx minus integral a to a plus dA by dt delta t dou f by dou t delta t dx plus integral b to b plus dB by dt delta t f dt plus integral b to b plus dv by dt into delta t dou f by dou t into delta t dx minus integral a to b f dx by whole divided by delta t. So here we could see that f dx and f dx are similar, and coming to other terms, here the limit is from a to b, and we could see that we can cancel delta t and delta t, so we get integral a to b dou f by dou t dx minus, now here it is integral from a to a plus dy by dt delta t and of f dx. So we can write this whole as, let's write it, let's doesn't don't change it, let's keep it same. And now this is this term is from a to a plus dy by dt delta t, and also it is a multiplication with delta t, so it's an integration of a function in a small value and multiplication with a very small value, so we can just neglect this term. And similarly, we can neglect this term. So we are left with this term b plus dv by dt delta t f dt here it is dx. And now here if we observe this part, we could write the let's write it same similarly dou f by dou t dx, and this term can be written as f of a comma t dy by dt into delta t by delta t, and similarly this term can be written as f of b comma t
plus
dv by dt delta t by delta t
plus
here it is plus, and here it is plus. So how can we write this whole term as like this? If you observe, this integration is in a small limit from a to a plus dy by dt delta t. So let's assume that f is constant in this area, and that's and value of f is f a comma t. So, and we are integrating it in limit a to a plus dy by dt, and so we can directly write dy by dt here into delta t and the other term delta t. And similarly, we can write this third term here delta t and delta t gets cancelled. So finally, we got the formal statement of Leibniz integration rule, that is dx minus f of a comma t into dy by dt plus f of b comma t into dv by dt. This is equal to integral of d by dt of integral of a to b f of x comma t dt.